First of all, thank you again for this wonderful film and then for being here with us today. I'd like to start off by asking Moe about what first inspired you to make this film.
この映画のきっかけは私と実の母との関係をちょっと描こうと思ってこの映画を作りました。
The motivation for making this movie was to depict the relationship between myself and my mother.
Can you elaborate a little bit on that?
なんか母親とすごく仲が悪かった時に、もう母親が一生忘れられないような表情を私にしてきて、それがこの物語のきっかけですね。
There was a period of my life where I had quite a bad relationship with my mother, and she, her face had an expression towards me that I would never forget, during my whole lifetime.
And so the story itself is not so much inspired.
でも私にとっての母親がお肉間家具倉庫さん、お肉間と家具にそれぞれ要素が分かれていて、クシナは私自身で、で当時私をちょっと外の世界に引き寄せてた、まあ、映画なんですけどっていうものが倉庫さんという形で体現されてます。
In terms of the expression of what was happening there, you have the Onikuma and Kagu are the two characters, and in that situation, I myself was Kushina. So it was the outside world that was calling to me, which in this film was depicted by the presence of Soko.
So the question to Tomona here, so what drew you to the project when you first heard about it?
ことや出来事だと思ったので、それを本当当時あの時28歳だったんですけど、映画の実年齢と一緒に、なのでその等身大の時にあの役を演じたらどういうふうに自分が思うのかなという、ただ興味のもとに受けさせていただいたって感じですね。
I thought this was a story or a film that anyone could relate to in terms of what occurs. I actually was 28 in real life at the same time as my character on screen was 28. So I wondered how I would depict or how this would actually play out on screen in terms of these experiences.
And so question to both Moen and Ryo, who's up here with us today. I understand that the two of you worked very closely together on the film. And it clearly shows in the visual beauty that you show on screen here. Can you tell us more about your collaborative process, talking about the cinematography and what kind of visual references you may have consulted?
視覚的には監督と最初話したのは、どのカットを撮ってもその絵画っていうか絵っていうか絵画みたいな感じにはしたいっていう注文は受けていて、で監督と一緒にその美術館に行ったりしてモチーフの作品とか見て、でまあそういう、そうですね、結構ぴったりの絵があって、このクシナにそれでまあ脚本とも合ってるし、そういう結構絵みたいに撮ってこうとは思ったんですけど、カメラは決してそのなんていうんですかね、フィックスせずに結構人も動いてるし、カメラも結構まあめちゃめちゃに動いたりはしてるんで、まあその約束が守れたか分かんないんですけど、まあ結果的にはそういうふうになったとは自分では思ってますね。
In terms of visually, how we wanted to make this movie, when I spoke with the director for the first time, what she had said to me was that no matter what cut we were looking at, that she wanted it to be like a picture or a painting. That was the visual image that she was looking for. We actually went together to museums to receive inspiration from different works and motifs. And so I looked at different images that I thought would be perfect for Kushina and that would match the screenplay to create this image of a picture or a painting. That being said, we didn't have the camera fixed. I moved it along with the people who were moving, and I moved the camera around a lot. I don't know if I kept to my original promise, but that's how I was in terms of filming this movie. That was what I was decisive about.
Do you have anything to add?
なんで私はあまり映画的なこのカットのつなぎっていうのは得意ではなか だし、まず自分が持ってるイメージとしてすごいクシナっていう映画の大きな一枚絵があって、でなんかなんだろう、最後の審判とかそういう大きな絵のイメージがあって、そのピースを取っていくような気持ちでした。
In terms of the actual techniques that were in the film, connecting the cuts and those sorts of things, I'm not really as well versed. But my image of Krishna was to have it as one big picture or painting. For example, let's say in that last scene. So it was just a matter of taking the different images to put together to create that larger picture.
And so while you weren't the cinematographer for the film, I understand, Moe, that you were doing many roles in the production of this film. You weren't only the writer and the director, but you were also in charge of costume design as well as the art direction. Can you speak more about doing all these various roles, why you decided to take them all on, and what it was like doing so?
理由はでも2つあって、1つはやっぱり自分のイメージを直接形にするには自分がやった方が一番手っ取り早いっていうのはあったんですけど、まあ、予算的な問題で、まあ、コスチュームだったり美術を雇うことができなかったっていうのもあります。
There's actually two reasons for that. One is that in terms of directly conveying the image of the film I wanted to make, I thought that by directing it myself, that would be the fastest and most efficient way. The second reason was budgetary. For cost reasons, I wasn't able to hire a costume designer or an art designer, which is why I took on the role by myself.
Yeah, and what we see on screen is really amazing and colorful. Can you talk more about the process of choosing what you show on screen?
そのさっき撮影監督が言ってたみたいに、まあ、一つの一枚の絵をモチーフに始めたんですけど、その絵にはすごいディティールが入っていて、まあ、布であったり奥行きであったり光や影であったり、いろんな要素がその一枚に入っていて、そういうことは常に意識して画角の中に入れるようにしました。
Earlier we heard from the cinematographer that the image was to create one large picture or painting. That was the motif that we had. Of course, within this one painting or picture, there were different elements, different fabrics. We had the silk, we had different depth, light. There were all these different elements that were part of it. And that was something that was always in the back of my mind.
And as I mentioned at the beginning of the film, this film we awarded the Japan Cuts Award at the Osaka Asian Film Festival, and that really the criteria for that for us is to find really new and unique talent that we're really excited about, and that does also include Tomona Hirota herself, who's here with us tonight, and she's been popping up on many times on our screen, and in fact she's coming back on Friday for our experimental film showcase, which isI promise you, it's not, you don't want to miss this because it's a really wonderful array of films that we're presenting that night. So I hope you come back for that. But I want to also say, so for this film, Moe, why did you decide to cast Tomona?
いや、家具役を決めるのはすごい難しくて、何人かの女性に出会ったんですけど決定打がありませんでした。で、以前から広田さんの存在は知っていて、でお会いしたんですけれども、なんか彼女見た目はすごい個性的で強そうに見えるんですけど、彼女と話した時にすごい透き通ったガラスのような目で私をずっと見てくれて、なんかすごい受け入れてくれていて、でなんかその表面は強いんですけど、なんか中にすごい弱いものを持っているそういうレイヤーがカグーっていうキャラクターに重なって、彼女ならできる、信頼できると思ってお願いしました。
It was actually quite difficult to cast for the role of Kagu. I had spoken with auditioned several different women, but wasn't able to make a decision. And I'd actually spoken to Tomono-san previously, and when we met, I thought that she really had the appearance and the feeling of being very individualistic. So I thought that she would be good for the role. She seemed very strong in terms of her appearance, but she also had a very a way of looking at me, sort of a way of transparency that she looked at me, and I felt like she could really see me and that she was receiving me. So again, on the surface, surface she seemed quite strong, but then there was also a weaker portion that I could see within her. She had different layers to her character, and I thought that actually sunk was perfectly syncing with the character of Kagu. So that was a reason I thought that I could trust her in this role, that she would be the right person for it.
And Tomona, can you tell us what it was like preparing and acting as Kagu?
そうですね、準備は特にせず、今まで自分が生きてきたことを信じて、あと監督が言ってくれた言葉を信じて、その通りにやっただけですね。はい。
There was nothing extensive in terms of preparation. It was pretty much believing in what I had experienced or lived up until that point, as well as relying on what the director said to me.
And so I really think that this film has these wonderfully complicated characters that are fleshed out so well, and there's all these different dynamics that are presented between the characters. Can you talk about how you sort of map these relationships up? Did you start with an anthropologist character, or where did you begin?
最初は映画のきっかけは、まあ、母と私って言ったんですけど、まあ、我らが感じていたこの感情をもとにまずキャラクターを作りました。で、ある程度キャラクターを自由に動かして脚本を書いていたんですね。で、まあ、その時にじゃあこの物語を引き出すにはこういう人物を投入したら効果的だなとか思って、それで生まれてきたのが人類学者ですね。
As I said earlier, this film was born from wanting to depict the relationship I had with my mother, and I created the characters based on the emotions that we were feeling at that time. Within that, to a certain extent, I wanted to make my characters have freedom to move throughout the movie, and that was the way that I wrote the screenplay. At that time, within the story, I thought if we had these characters come into the film, it would enable the story to unfold, which is how I came to stumble upon the anthropologist roles.
And I understand that your mother is in the theater. Mother's over there. And so with that, I want to start opening questions out into the theater. So if you have a question, please raise your hand and we'll pass a mic along to you. So we have a question right there, the white t-shirt.
Hi, thank you for sharing your movie with us. You guys have a very affectionate eye for nature. The forest is almost personified in the way you shot and edited your movie, and I'm wondering what relationship nature has to the story.
なんだろうな、多分そういう質問を受けたのは2度目なんですけれども、私自身でも意識して自然をキャラクターにしたわけではないんですが、でも自分自身が持っているなんだろうこう今まで育ってきた環境で、宮崎駿のナウシカであったりもののけ姫とかを見ていて、多分この自然の脅威っていうもの、人間にはコントロールできないもの、なんかそういうのが自然と自分の中にあって、できっと今回の母親親子の物語を描く上で、なんかそういう環境が相性が良かったんですよね。
That's actually the second time I've received this question. It wasn't something that I was particularly conscious of in trying to make nature almost like another character, but I think it was something that I had within myself. In terms of the environment that I was raised in, I was a big fan of the Hayao Miyazaki movies, Naoshika, Princess Mononoke. So that actually had an influence on me in terms of nature being a threat that us as humans can't control. I think this perception was inside me naturally. The other part was that, again, wanting to depict the story of between the mother and the daughter, I think within that, this environment seemed to be the most compatible.
Question up front here.
Hi, first of all, I wanted to say arigatou gozaimasu for that wonderful movie. And I wanted to ask you, so I know you said you started small in the movie from the idea, but in the end, throughout the whole movie, it seemed that many situations have been left a little bit up to, you know, interpretation. So the especially the relationships, but also certain consequences, you know, between Kagu and her mother, but also, you know, the daughter. So I just wanted to see, was that intended or did it just happen by finishing the movie like this?
うん、私の中ではすごくすっきりしていて考え方は。でただ、うん、なんだろうな、そうですね、曖昧な部分は意図的に最初、意図的ではなかった、撮影当時は。でも編集をしていく上でなんかもう少し考え方が変わったというか、なんかすいません。
So within me, the way of thinking, it was actually pretty clear. I had a very clear sense of what I wanted to do in terms of accomplishing what I want to accomplish. But in terms of being intentional, in terms of leaving it vague or having different interpretations, when I was filming, that wasn't the case. It actually, when I went into the editing process, is when I my way of thinking changed slightly.
でもこの撮影の撮影の前日にシーンを20から30シーンぐらい削ったんです、実は。でまあそれは多分経験のあるスタッフから、これじゃあ君は初めてだし取りきれないよって言われて、で削ったんですけど、その部分に結構個人パーなんだろう、キャラクターをちょっと深く描いた部分であったり、ちょっと関係性を描いた部分もあったので、なんかそういった意味ではちょっとそれがなくなったことによりちょっと分かりづらくなったのかなとは思っております。
But actually, the day before filming, I was told by some of my more experienced staff that it might be beneficial to cut some of the scenes, which I actually ended up doing, about 20 to 30 different scenes. They told me that it was my first time, this was my debut, I wouldn't be able to film all those scenes. So as a result, it actually ended up depicting the characters and the relationships. They were perhaps less fleshed out than I originally intended. So that might be part of why it was a bit open to interpretation or hard to understand.
Question up here.
Hi. So you were talking a bit about motifs earlier with silk and other types of just production stuff. So could you talk a little bit about the motifs and what they mean throughout the film?
モチーフにしたのは、フレデリック・レイトンのスタディっていうペインティングがあるんです。で、何でしたっけ？
Actually, the main motif was based on a painting by Frederick Leighton called Study at a Reading Desk, which actually portrays a young girl.
Great. Other questions? Oh, back there.
Yes. I may have missed something in my interpretation of this very interesting film. The idea of a community of women, is a sort of feminist. I happen to be a professor of women's studies or was, and so forth. And I'm just wondering if there's a feminist perspective that underlies this film. And I've very almost never seen a Japanese film, and I've seen a number, that deals with the community of women. So I'm really interested in how the director-writer came up with this kind of theme. Thank you.
Great question.
フェミニストを意識したわけではなくて、あくまでもこの母親と子供の愛を描く上で登場人物を考えて人物を動かしていると、男性が必要なかったで、そうですね、ただこれは何だろう、私の育った環境でもあると思うんです、はい、決して男性が不必要とかそういうわけではなくて、なんか私の父親はそんなお家にいることはそんなないんですけど、いることはありますけど仕事で忙しくて、うん、でもすごい外から大きい枠で見た時にいつもサポートしてくれている人であったので、多分そういう私の人生が反映されて、ああいうコミュニティが生まれたんだと思ってます。
In terms of being conscious of the feminist aspect of the film, that wasn't really the case. It really was more to the extent of wanting to depict the love between the mother and the daughter. For that purpose, that's why I created these characters and had them behave the way they do. It was just more that men weren't essential for the purpose of telling that story. And this actually reflects the environment that I was raised in. Not to say that I did not need a male presence in my environment. My father was just busy with work and whatnot, so wasn't always in the house. But I sensed his presence from outside, being a very supportive, a large presence. But I think that the creation of this community of women really does reflect my own life experiences.
Other question? Okay, we'll take a question towards the back.
Hi, I was curious about the imagery of the rosaries throughout the film and whether or not that was more a motif of, once again, kind of the outside invading, or was it more to do with your own experience with Western faith or any faith in particular?
この登場人物の中で、倉庫さんが一番近代的で、まあ、外の世界からやってきた人なんですけれども、まあ、彼女は一見自由に見えて、ただそのクリスチャンということによって、彼女がそうなんだろう彼女は自分の選択ではなくても、彼女の家系がクリスチャンだからクリスチャンなんですけど、なんかその自分が生まれながらにして持っているしがらみっていうものを彼女は無意識のうちに抱えているっていうイメージです。で、私はクリスチャンではないんですけど、まあ、クリスチャンの幼稚園にはいてて、でなんかでもお家にはクリスチャンのものだったり、でもなんだろうな、日本の宗教のものだったり、いろんなものが家に入り混じってて、mm-hmm. そういうバックグラウンドがあったから思いついた発想だと思います。
Within the story, the character who's the most modern is Soko. She's coming from the outside, bringing the presence of the outside world. So at first glance, it seems that she's very free in terms of her character. But because she was raised Christian, this was not something that she chose. It was something that she had grown up with. And it's almost as if it was something that had shackled her, that she had just been born with, and she was unconsciously shackled by this religion. In my case, I was not particularly raised Christian, but I did go to a Christian kindergarten. In my house, there was a mixture of different religious aspects. We did have Christian stories. I also had some Japanese religious stories. But I think, again, it was this background that played into the creation of that idea.
Other questions? Is that a hand? No. Oh, it's a hand right here.
どうもありがとうございました。とっても楽しく見せていただきました。 それで質問ではないんですけど、これは夢のようなね作品だと思って、例えばあのクシノもみんなね、皆さんすごい高価なね絞り染めだったりお着物がすごく高価なものばっかり着せてあって、それであんな山の中でねあのお着物が素敵でした、それであの着物もすごく素敵です。
ありがとうございます。 Thank you for the comment.
This was just a comment, not a question, but first of all, I'd like to say thank you. It was an extremely enjoyable film. I almost felt like I was experiencing it while watching it, while being in it, having a dream. For Kushina and all the other characters, I was amazed that despite living in this mountainous area up in the woods, that they had these gorgeous, elaborate kimono. I was really struck by how beautiful they were, so I just wanted to comment on that.
Well, so I think as a last question, I wanted to mention that I was really struck by the use of sound also in the film. We've been talking about the visuals, but the way you sort of build the soundscape really helped to sort of help me get into the film when I was watching it. And of course, music itself plays a huge role in the film. You have the very iconic shot of Kushina listening to something on a Walkman. And then, of course, after the credits, we saw Que sera sera play out. Yeah, can you talk about your music and sound choices?
その現場の音っていうのが、あんまり核をついてないというかちょっといい音ではなかったので、いっそのことこれだったら作り直そうということで音は、アメリカで 4D をしてもらって、で、アフレコもちょっとして音にはちょっとこだわりました。で、音楽もそれぞれのキャラクターをイメージした音楽をまずチョイスして当てるようにしたり、あとケセラセラについてはこれもまた母と私の話になるんですけど、お互いが持ってた共通点だったので今回使いました。
In terms of the sound, during the filming stage, I asked the person in charge of recording and sound to pick up all the different sounds that could be found where we were filming. But because we had almost no budget, we didn't really have a lot of mics to pick up the sound properly. So as a result, the sound was really not what we wanted it to be. So a lot of effort went into fixing the sound during the process afterwards in terms of fixing the recording, and that was something I was very particular about. Another aspect was in terms of the music, I picked songs or music that would match the different characters in my images of them. And finally, you referenced Que Sera Sera. That song actually is very emblematic of my relationship with my mother. It was one of our common points.
And so final comments from all three of you. What do you hope people take away from this film?
そうですね、楽しんでいただければそれが一番です。映画なので難しいことは考えずに、以上です。
I have to say that because it's a film, I'm not going to give you a very complicated answer. I just hope that it was an experience you enjoyed while watching it.
はい、私からはいろんなテーマがすごい複雑に絡み合った映画に一見見えるようですが、すごい大事なことが一つあって、それは監督が多分言いたかったことで、きっと恥ずかしいですけど、ラブ、愛なんですけど、本当に複雑な話ではあるので、ただこれは結構日本人の今の若い私たちの世代20代が抱える現代的なことを象徴している映画だと本当に思っております。なのでこれを私たちは受けて考えながらまたこう創作をしていって、これまた皆様に見てもらえるように頑張っていきたいです。ありがとうございます。
In terms of this film, there's a lot of complicated themes that seem to be wrapped up within it. But I think there's one thing, if I had to emphasize over anything else in terms of importance, and this is something I believe the director probably wanted to say, but was a little embarrassed to say, is that love is the overarching theme of the film. But there actually are many complicated aspects of the film. And I think it's very symbolic of the younger generation of Japan, people in their 20s, such as us, appear on stage. So for that purpose, we actually worked really hard to get people to watch this film and have it stimulate different kinds of thinking. So that's what I would have to say about that.
もう最後の締めですね。
I have to have the last word.
今日は本当に来てくださってありがとうございます。まあ、こうやってクシナが映画になったわけですが、皆さんのおかげで、ね、でもこれは挑戦の始まりにしか過ぎなくて、もっともっとやりたいこと、もっともっと私が作りたい世界があるので、まあ、ぜひ応援していただけると嬉しいです。
First, I'd like to thank everyone for coming out tonight. I really appreciate it. It's thanks to viewers like you that we were able to make Kushina into the film that it is. But I do have to say, this is actually just the start of what I would like to aspire to. I have many more stories that I would like to depict and many more films that I would like to make. So I ask for your support going forward as well.
Yeah, and on behalf of Japan Cuts, we're excited about what they'll do.